What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being confident? Hey everyone, welcome to this week's videos. You have all been awesome at either putting a video or a photo underneath the Facebook post to get credit for class or emailing the MAK Beats COVID account. But just a reminder that if you are doing this class, make sure you are doing that so that you get class credit. And also, if you have any feedback for me on what you like seeing or what you want to see more of or what you want to see differently, I would appreciate that because these videos are for you. So I want to make sure that it's the best it can be for all of you. All right, well, with that reminder, we're going to start class as always with our student creed. So feet together, hands by your side. I'm a dedicated martial artist. Student creed begin. I must develop myself in a positive manner and avoid anything that could reduce my mental growth or physical health. Number two, I must develop self-discipline in order to bring out the best in myself and others. Number three, I must use common sense before self-defense and never be abusive or offensive. Number four, winners never quit, quitters never win. I choose to be a winner. Number five, this is a black belt school. We are dedicated. We are motivated. We are on a quest to be our best. Asa, ready, set, courtesy. So this month we're talking about intensity. Say intensity. In intensity, we'll be earning our red stripe, and red represents fire, all right? Intensity, as a reminder, what it means is a physical example of our seriousness. So we can do that by things like having a mean face, showing our intent behind that when we do our moves, having loud kiyas, having strength behind our moves. Those are different ways that you could show intensity. And last week we talked about intensity levels. We need to be able to control our intensity. We don't always have to be all the way intense all the time. We might need to have a level one intensity, so just barely any. A level five intensity, which is a little more than level one, but not all of the way. And then there's 10, which is all of the way full intensity level. All right, so those were our levels. What we're gonna do today to test our intensity and work on our intensity is I'm gonna do a move. I'll tell you what the move is and what level of intensity I'm doing. Your job is to be like a mirror. So you're gonna do the same move at the same level of intensity, but the little challenge is you wanna try to do it just a little bit better than me. So adding a little bit more intensity than I'm adding or adding something to make it a little bit better than what I'm doing. All right, so that's our talk about intensity. That's the drill we're gonna do for today. You're gonna see me come on screen. Like I said, listen for what level intensity it is. Watch the move. It's all gonna be moves from your form or technique from this month, and let's bring it. All right, level intensity one, spear eyes, eyes, eyes. Level intensity five, spear eyes, eyes, eyes. Level intensity 10, spear eyes, eyes, eyes. Level intensity one, spear hands, throat, throat, throat. Level intensity five, spear hand, throat. Throat, throat. Level intensity 10, spear hand, throat. Throat, throat. Level intensity 1, step behind back fist. Ayah. Level intensity 5, step behind back fist. Ayah. Level intensity 10, step behind back fist. Ayah. Level intensity 10, spear eyes. Eyes, eyes. Level intensity 10, step behind back fist. Ayah! Level intensity 10, spear hand throat. Throat, throat! Level intensity 1, step behind back fist. Ayah! Level intensity 1, spear hands throat. Throat, throat! Level intensity 10, step behind back fist. Ayah! Level intensity 1, spear hands throat. Throat, throat. Level intensity 5, spear eyes. Eyes, eyes. Level intensity 1, step behind back fist. Yeah. Level intensity 10. Spear hand throat. Throat throat. Level intensity 10. Spear hand throat. Throat throat. Level intensity 1. Step behind back fist. Yeah. Level intensity 10. Step behind back fist. Yeah. Level intensity 1. Spear hands throat. Throat throat. Level intensity 5. Spear hand throat. Throat throat. Level intensity 5, spear eyes. Eyes, eyes. Level intensity 10, spear hand throat. Throat, throat. Level intensity 1, step behind back fist. Yeah. Level intensity 1, step behind back fist. Yeah. Level intensity 10, step behind back fist. Yeah.
All right, so the other word we're working on this month, our black belt lifestyle skill word, or our star word, so this is the word that you'll need to fill out your star sheet for stripe test, is confidence. Say confidence. Now, confidence is believing in yourself, knowing your worth, knowing how good you are. And as a martial artist, it's really important that we're confident in the skills that we have to defend ourselves if we ever needed to. But the other part about confidence is we don't want to be conceited, right? We don't want to think we're the absolute best and be mocking other people or preventing ourselves from getting even better. All right, we want to have modesty. We want to have a balance of both. And what we're going to talk about this week when we're talking about confidence is what I want you to do actually is picture someone in your life. It could be a family member, a friend, a teacher, someone you've seen on TV who has confidence. Think about that person. And that person, because they believe in themselves, they're probably really uplifting, maybe inspiring. They're someone who, you know, you might look up to. Those are all qualities of someone who's confident. When we're not confident, we might be feeling insecure, right? We might be questioning our abilities, questioning ourselves, questioning our worth. Think of someone who you know who might be insecure. All right, hopefully you have someone in mind. And that person, because they're questioning themselves, they might be negative, right? They might be, you know, down on themselves, down on the people around them. So that's why it's important for us to have confidence. We want to have that belief in ourselves. So I want you to think about that as we keep training through the rest of class today. So we're going to go into the form portion of the video for today. And before we actually even go into like doing the form, I'm going to review the spear hands because we have more spear hands in this section of the form. So remember, a spear, when we're thinking about a spear, we're thinking about a really long stick. And at the end of that stick is a triangle shaped pointy object. It might be a rock if it's like, you know, made from the ground, or it might be if it's made in a, like a factory, it might have like a metal triangle at the end that's really sharp. But that sharp part is the part that's used to stab into whatever the person using the spear is trying to do. So if it was being used for hunting back in the day, you know, stab into the animal that they were using to have food. If it's in the self-defense, you know, stabbing into the person who's trying to harm us or take our life away. So that's what we're thinking about when we make our hands into spears. So everybody do this with me. Make your hand like a spear. And what we're going to do is to make your hand like a spear, you think of it as that pointy triangle at the end. So I'm going to use this hand to show you the spear, or this hand to be the spear, and this hand's going to kind of show you things. So I want to point out again, your thumb is tucked to the side here. All right, we don't want it sticking out like this. We want it tucked to the side. And notice my fingers are really tight together. All right, some of you have your fingers spread, I've noticed. Make sure those fingers are tight together. So your thumb is tucked tight, your fingers are tight together, because you want to make as much of a triangle shape with the tops of your fingers as you can. If we have them spread out, that's not a triangle shape, right? That's like a high five. All right, so nice and tight, fingers together. And this is the part we're thinking about pointing into our target. So last week we thought about pointing our spear hand into the eyes and the throat. All right. This week, what we're going to do is we're actually going to point our spears so our hands, our palms of our hands are facing up. We're going to cup our spear slightly so you can see there's a slight bend. And what we're doing is called an inverted spear hand. I want you to say that. Say inverted spear hand. Now put the words together. Say inverted spear hand. When we have an inverted spear hand, I want you to take your hands, your regular hands, feel where your ribs are. All right, what you're doing with your inverted spear hands is you're towards the center where your ribs come in to meet the center. You're taking your spear hands and you're shoving them into somebody there. That's what your target is. All right, so let's visualize that. Let's take our spear hands, invert them. Fun fact, if you don't know what the word invert means, it means to like flip around. So that's what we're doing, right? Our hands are flipped around. So we have our inverted spear hands and you're gonna push them like you're stabbing underneath the rib cage. So every time I say go, you're gonna say ribs, ribs. All right, so throw both of them. Make sure you're starting with your right hand. It might look like it's my left on the video because of technology, but make sure you're using your right hand first. All right, and if you have a hard time with your right and your left, don't worry, you're not alone. I also have a hard time with my right and my left. Ask an adult to help you, all right? Ask them to, you know, maybe watch what you're doing and make sure you're using your right hand first, all right? So every time I say go, you're gonna do both inverted spears and you're gonna say ribs, ribs on each attack, all right? Go, ribs, ribs, and bring it right back every time. Go, ribs, ribs. Right back. So when your hands are attacking for right now, for terms of practicing, they're on the sides ready to attack, all right, as you can see. Go, ribs, ribs. One more time together. Go, ribs, ribs. All right, so that is gonna be one move in our form. Another move we're gonna do is called a crane stance. Say that, say crane stance. And I'm not sure if you've ever seen a crane before, but it's a type of bird, and the bird has really long, skinny legs, and sometimes they just stand on their one leg in the water. So that's what we're gonna do, is we're gonna stand on one leg, so practice this with me. Again, make sure you know your right and your left, and if not, have an adult help you. Your right leg is the one that stays on the ground. The left leg is gonna come up. All right, so we're gonna work our way up to standing in the crane stance. So all we're gonna do for now is every time I say go, I want you to just lift your foot up off the ground. Alrighty, and practice balancing. Ready? Go. And down. Try to hold it up the whole time that I'm holding it. If you have to touch the ground and pull it back up, that's okay. We're learning and growing together, okay? Go. Good. So the first time we did 3 seconds. Second time we did 5 seconds. Now we're gonna do 10 seconds. Ready? Go! And down. Nice job. So now instead of just bringing our leg up, what we're actually gonna do is hook our leg behind the back of our other leg. So the left leg that comes up hooks behind the right leg that stays straight. I'm gonna turn around so you can see what it looks like in the back. So my left leg comes up and hooks around the back of my other leg. Right, you can see how it comes across my calf and hooks on the other side. This actually helps you stand and have more balance. Right, and I'll do a side angle too. Comes around the side, do side this way, comes around the side. All right, so when I say crane stance, what you're gonna do is do just that. You're gonna stay in your crane stance, try to balance. If you need to put your hands out for now, you can, but we will be adding something on with the hands too. All right, ready? Crane stance. Good, and down. Same thing, we did 3 seconds, now we're gonna challenge to 5, then we're gonna challenge to 10. If you have to put your foot down in between, that's okay, right? We're learning and growing and building our balance together. Crane stance. Good, see I wobbled a bit there. That's okay, we're getting better every time. And now for 10 seconds, crane stance.
and down. So I told you I was going to tell you that we have something to do with the hands. What I want you to do is forget the feet for now. We're going to just stand still with our feet. What our hands are going to do is you're going to take your left hand and you're going to chop down low. Ready? So chop. Like someone's trying to kick you in the butt and you're chopping them. Ready? Chop. Again, chop. So it's that knife hand that we have when we do our reverse bow. You're taking the pinky blade part and you're hitting the attacker, preventing them from hitting you. Two more times, ready? Chop. Last one, chop. Good. Now we're gonna use our other hand, our right hand, and someone's trying to hit you over the head, you're gonna keep your hand open and you're gonna block. All right, so you're using this part of your hand and you're blocking. Someone's trying to hit you in the head, you're blocking. All right, so every time I say block or high block, you're gonna do that high block. Ready? High block. Good. And it should be your right hand, so it's your high block with your right hand. High block. High block. High block. Good. Now we're gonna put this chop and the high block together. So every time I say go, you're going to chop and high block at the same time. So it looks like this. Go. All right, so do it with me. Ready? Go. Good, and when you're doing this, add that kia in. So every time you're doing either a block or a punch, you're saying kia, you're reminding yourself to breathe, and you're bringing that intensity in. Let's do it two more times together. Go. Did you kia? Go. Good. Let's bring it all together. So the last move of this form, just watch, don't do it with me yet. You're bringing your leg up as you start to bring your hands up. When your leg settles or wraps around, that's when you're throwing a chop and a high block. All right? So it looks like this. Yeah. All right, so let's practice that. Let's do it three times together. Every time I say go, you're going to get into that crane stance, throw your chop and your high block all together. Are you ready? Let's go. Ready? Go. Ida. And back. Go. Ida. Back. Last time. Go. Ida. And back. And we want to be able to hold it, right? So let's do it one more time actually together. And we're going to see if we can freeze there for 10 seconds. Alrighty, I'll count this up this time. Go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice job, give yourself a hand. So those are all the different moves. Now we're gonna throw them together and practice the form. So this is action party form 2, part B, part B. So it's the second half of part B, all right? So let's have a little fun with this. Repeat after me. Action karate form 2, part B, bam! And we're gonna go right into our horse dance. Aya! Move number 1 is those inverted spears. So I'm gonna say go. You're gonna do spear, spear, and freeze. And you're gonna say ribs, ribs. Ready? Go! Ribs, ribs. And now, move number 2 is what we just worked on. It's that crane stance, chop, high block, all together. Ready? 2. Yeah. And then set. Victory. Humility. Courtesy. Man. So there's not a lot of moves in this part B of part B, but that's because we want to focus on those details and make sure we have them down, and that the two moves that we have, because there's kind of multiple parts to it, we do it really well. All right, so let's practice one more time together those two moves. Action karate form 2, part B, bam. Horse stance, aya. 1, ribs, ribs. 2, aya. Set. Victory. Humility. Courtesy. Man. So similarly to how you've practiced in the past, you're gonna see me come on screen. I'm gonna do that what we just did, and you're gonna follow along, practicing over and over again, just to try to get those moves down, all right? So let's go ahead and get some practice in. Thank you.
with being? What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being confident? What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being?
We're focusing on the second part, which is our punch and our kick. All right, it's really important that we do those two moves well because they're the part of the self-defense that really makes the person who's attacking us not only like stop attacking us, but stay away from us. All right, so fall back into your guard stance. Make sure your belly button's towards the left. You're gonna take your left hand, you're gonna do a reverse punch. All right, so you're punching the bad person to keep them away. Now we're gonna use our back leg because our back leg has more power. We're gonna do a front kick, and our goal with the front kick is to kick them and project them and to push them far away from us. All right, so really think about that when you're doing your kick. Ready? Go! And then our cover out. So now this, we just did the damage part of the self-defense so they don't come back and hurt us. Now we need to get away so they don't try to attack us again. So you're gonna step across, out, and then around. All right, and when we step around, notice, just watch me, you don't have to do this. I'm not stepping like this and looking away from them. You wanna keep your eyes at the bad person, at that target the whole time. So that's why when we step around, we step this way so we can keep our eyes on the bad person. Just like when we're doing our reverse bows in action karate form two. All right, so fall back in your guard stance. Ayah! Remember, we're facing the left. Left hand reverse punch, left front kick, land forward, and then cover out. Across, one step, out, two step, keep your eyes on the target, around, three step. Now I'm just gonna say go, and that's what you're gonna do. Ready? Go! Reverse punch, front kick, cover out, one step, two step, yeah! And time.
You know the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. What's that fever lighter? Doesn't mean I'm over, cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Trust me, myself and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. I'm alone. what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Just me, myself, and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
All right, go grab your weapon. We are gonna be doing nunchucks now for the last part of class. Remember, when you do grab your weapon, it's important to treat the weapon with respect. Part of that is asking the adult you live with to that it's okay to use a weapon in the house if you are practicing inside. Also, make sure that you check your space so you're not gonna hit anything with your weapon. All right, we don't want any broken lamps or broken TVs or anything like that. So go ahead and grab your nunchuck. Remember, whenever we hold our chuck, I'm going to keep on saying this because it's really important. We hold it close to the center. So if you have a string that connects or a chain, this is how we're holding it. All right, we might shift it a little bit when we're moving it around, but ultimately when we're swinging it and doing any spins or any strikes, it's close to the center like that. All right, when we hold it out here, we don't have control. In the middle, we have a little more control, but still, we don't have control over the weapon. So when we're doing spins or we're doing strikes, we need to have control. All right, so you're gonna start with in your right hand. What I want you to do, holding it close to the center, twirl backwards. Now, we're building off of what we've already learned. So this should be a review, but when we're twirling backwards, make sure we're just barely moving our wrists. We're not moving our whole arm, all right? We're just moving our wrists to get it to go backwards. And it's going backwards because the rotation, the strike is going backwards, all right? So it's going like this, towards the back. Keep twirling. Bring it up to your shoulder. And now we're going to do the triangle whip that we did before. So it comes across the body to the left, across to the right, and up. Now we're going to reach across, grab underneath, pull it out, bring it to the other side. So if we're going to the left, we're making a muscle with the left hand. The right hand slides down and comes underneath. We let go with the hand that is across our belly. Now we're gonna do forward circles. And you keep doing forward circles. I'm just gonna show you something though. It's called forward circles because the strike is coming forward. All right, that's how you know you're going forward circle. Ready? And then open your hand to let it fall. So we're gonna put all those things together now. You're gonna get into a horse stance. You're gonna do 5 twirl backwards. So make sure you're doing this with me. You're gonna do 3 triangle whips. 1, 2, 3. Reach across, come back out. You're gonna do 5 twirls forward, go down to your knee. 5 twirls backwards, 3 triangle whips. 1, 2, 3. Reach out and come back. All right, we're gonna do that one more time because I forgot the forward circles the first time on the other side. So let's do this together. Horse stance, come up to your shoulder. 5 forward twirls and then down to your knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 backward circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 triangle whips. 1, 2, 3. Reach in under, pull it out, put it on the other side. Same thing, 5 down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down. 5 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up. And then 3 triangle whips. 1, 2, 3. Reach it out, feet together, and then put the chalk together. All right, so that's your weapon set for this week. We're ending class as always with our principles of being a black belt. Feet together, hands by your side. Repeat after me. I'm a dedicated student of the martial arts. And I live by the principles of being a black belt. And they are integrity, concentration, perseverance, respect and obedience, self-control,
humility, indomitable spirit, knowledge, power, black belt, courtesy. Give yourself a hand. You are awesome.